Ohio, c'est Kunch de la Fume Steam, et aujourd'hui je repars avec mon petit soldat Senshi en découverte de ce monde vaste. Vaste. Donc voilà, j'ai pas trop compris la quest là. Monnaie ancien, ouais. Mac. J'ai pas compris la quête là. Ah, ça va être pas bête, hein, je crois que. Thank you. Waouh, je vois pas trop la question. Pourquoi ça marche pas? Ramène tes fraises. Ah bah c'est ça, ok. Ok. Good. Very good. Ok, c'est ça. Ok, merde. Tout à l'heure, je cherchais un truc, c'est pas ça. Ah, retournons là-bas. Je crois que je me trompe de côté. Ouais, mince là-bas.
When Marion caused the golden mark to flare on your arm, your muscles trembled. Memories flashed dizzyingly before your eyes. It was easy to assume they were your own life, but you soon saw grand cities unlike anything on New Year. It was as though you were looking out through someone else's eyes. As that person purchased fish in a marketplace, a mirror in a nearby booth reflected her face. A chestnut-haired young woman with milky skin and the refined features of a noble. The memory vanished as quickly as it had begun, leaving you unsteady. You wondered if Marion had caused you to see it, but she betrayed no knowledge of it. You'd always heard that when they died during the destruction of Auroria, the members of the library expedition passed their memories to the survivors of their races. Although time had faded those memories, some especially skilled individuals could recall them. Because the Aurorans passed through the hereafter on the way to safety during the Exodus, it was said that the goddess Nui's memories could be felt especially strongly. Before the journey had transformed her to the goddess Nui, she had been a charity-minded noblewoman named Diana. Your golden mark burned. Another memory appeared. A charming, hooded vagrant begging for food. Spoke of Lucius, which she did often, crediting him with the carnage you saw. The more memories seemed to fill your head. It was clear they were Rihanna's. She apparently used her family's wealth to run a soup kitchen for the city's poor. You saw the smiling vagrant begging for food from the soup kitchen every day. Heard Diana eventually chastise him for being able-bodied but relying on charity. With a laugh, he handed her two tickets to a play in a local theater. As more memories flashed, you shared Diana's realization that this man was Lucius Quinto, a famous playwright. Could this be Marion's Lucius? What kind of playwright could commit such carnage? Especially one who seems so charming.
Et voilà, j'ai oublié de rallumer mon micro, donc c'est reparti. Une petite pause de quelques minutes. Et... clairement. Original quand même. Ah mais shit. Sérieusement, bro. Waouh, j'ai fait le faire piquer sous le nez celui-là. Thank you. j'aurais cru qu'on devait faire ça. Bon, mais je pense que ce sera tout pour aujourd'hui, enfin du moins pour épisode 2. Je vais laisser pas faire un truc long. Donc là, c'est le début des quêtes à Nuya. Donc de quête en quête, de tuer des monstres à mon avis. Je ferai une vidéo quand je serai vers la capitale, de préférence. Donc voilà, je vous dis à plus tard pour d'autres aventures. Salut.